Hello guys, so welcome to my channel. So guys, if you have any sound issues in any of my videos, please use headphones and it will be all right. So this video will be part 3, lifeboat inspection. So in my previous videos I had covered about lifeboat equipments and fittings, and the second part of the lifeboat inspection was lifeboat davits, launching and recovery arrangements. So in this video I will be covering engines, batteries and lightings. So here I start. Now, so far as engines are concerned, we have to do weekly inspection, and a weekly inspection of trying out the engines, which should be not less than 3 minutes. So this is a SOLAS requirement to try out the engines, and the time is been given, not less than 3 minutes we have to try out. Now this not less than 3 minutes, in this we have to cover the head movement and astern movement both together. So it is, the total time should be not less than 3 minutes. That is what it says. So whenever you try out engines, now we have a lifeboat. This is a one of the lifeboat where we have two batteries. This is number one and this is number two. So here we can see the voltage of the battery. So it depends on different make and model where you can see the voltage of the lifeboat battery. So for example, now if I want to change over my battery to battery number one, now it is in off position. I want the power to be consumed from number one battery. So I will switch over this knob to number one. So that time the power will be consumed from number one. Similarly, if I want to consume the power from battery number two, so I have to switch over to the right side direction, that will be number two. And if I want to use the power of both the batteries together, there is option for both. So here you can use the power of both the batteries. Now whenever I start my engines, I have to make sure that I disconnect the battery cable, and then only I will start my engines by connecting in one of the batteries. Now we have to make sure that we try out the engine by trying out individual batteries, first number one, then number two, and then both. We have to try out our engines in all these three modes of battery consumption. So that is very important. Now whenever I say trying out engine, it not only means just trying out engines, especially we have to do certain other checks. So first we will see the video of this lifeboat inspection engine tryout. So after seeing the video, I want to convey that engine trying out is not only the only thing which we have to do in weekly inspection. Trying out engine also means we have to check the condition of the propeller, check the condition of the blades, check whether it has a propeller guard. So these things are very important. Now after checking of the propeller, we have to check all the connections of the engine. Whatever the connections which are going, they should not be rusted, because over a period of time these pipings will get rusted and they may start leaking, or these connections may start leaking. And we have to pay special attention to the bottom area of the engine, because most of the lifeboats, the bottom area of the lifeboat engine nobody inspects, and that becomes rusted, and because of that the thickness of the engine, this casing becomes less, and because of that there may be little problems, especially the fuel tank which is there. We have to check the fuel whenever we start the engine, so we have to check the condition of the fuel tank, because most of the time the fuel tank leaks from the bottom area. So that is why the inspection, thorough inspection, is very important, and that should be done weekly basis. Similarly, as you can see here, this is the crankshaft of the lifeboat engine. So inside this we have a bilge type arrangement, bilge area, So here also the water gets accumulated. Sometimes the windows of the lifeboat leaks, or sometimes the hook arrangement leaks from where the water ingress is possible, and because of that the bilge area gets filled with water, and at that time trying out engines is very, very damaging, because it may take suction or anything might happen, the water may go inside any of the part of the engine. So that is why we have to inspect these things before we try out engine. And also this portion, you can see this grease nipple, you have to make sure that this is not rusted. The visual inspection should be proper. So after weekly inspection, we have only one inspection, that is weekly inspection for the engines. So after that we have monthly inspection. So in monthly inspection we have to check the embarkation lights. So this embarkation lights should be operational. We have to check this monthly basis. So especially this lights are being tested when we try out the abandoned ship drill, which is monthly. So that time when all people are gathered, we switch on our emergency lights and we check whether they are operation or not. So whenever we inspect the lights, this is mostly done by electrical officers. So whenever we check the lights, we have to check the casing of this light. Inside that, there should be no moisture content, and this should not be painted over, or there should not be any paint marks, which basically minimizes the intensity or illumination of the lights. That's why there should be no paint marks in this. Especially this rotating lights. Now these lights should be painted red, because these are emergency lights. Similar to this light also, this should be red in color. So this has to be painted red, and the swivel arrangement which is there, this location. Now we have to make sure that this is free to rotate. The light should be free to rotate, and it should be well greased, and no rust should be there, because if the rust is there, it will cause hindrance to the free rotation of this light. So that is why it is very important to check the condition and make sure you do monthly greasing on this type of swivel arrangement. So after embarkation lights, we have batteries and battery charger inspection. So this, let's say this is the batteries of the lifeboat. So electrical officer basically does the monthly inspection of these batteries. So basically he will be maintaining a log where he will be maintaining the charge and the density of the electrolyte of these batteries, and he will make sure that the lifeboat charging plug, this is properly connected and it is charging. This is very important, because most of the time what happens is that whenever we try out engines, we just remove the charging plug and after that we forget to again plug it down. And also if we are carrying out some inspection here or some maintenance, then also let's say if we remove this plug due to any of the reason and after maintenance we forget to put it inside, so that is why inspection or the whether it is plugged and whether it is charging or not, that is very important. So after this we have engine toolkit inspection. Now this is also, this is to be done by mostly third engineers do this inspection. Basically they have to check whether the toolkit has all the necessary items for any emergency whenever we are in lifeboat. So similar box arrangement we will be having. So we will be having one set of inlet and exhaust valve with spring washers and cotters, one fuel injection nozzle, one fuel pipe, one set of pressure joints, one spare flexible hose of each size used in the engine, then screwdrivers, pliers, spanners, instruction manual, then laminated waterproof card of engine fault location chart, etc. How to locate the fault, all that, and cold spray start equipments. So that should be all there in this lifeboat equipments. And it is also recommended to mark the lifeboat tools with distinctive paint to prevent removal from the boat. That is very important, because most of the time people just took it away but they never return back to the same box. So that is why Angel Toolkit is a very important. Now it's a part of a lifeboat equipment, but the inspection has to be done by third engineer and not third officer. So after the monthly inspection, there is a quarterly inspection. Quarterly inspection only has one inspection, that is inspecting the lifeboat engines. Now lifeboat engine, there's a requirement as per LSA code that it should start in minus 15 degrees Celsius temperature within 2 minutes of commencing the starting operation. So if I press the start button within 2 minutes at minus 15 degrees Celsius, the lifeboat engine should start. So now this quarterly inspection basically is tested when we lower the lifeboat and maneuver the lifeboat. That time these lifeboat engines are tried out. But we also have to inspect. Now, as you can see here, now this is the throttle where we can give ahead and astern. So whenever we give ahead, we have to make sure that the lifeboat goes ahead. And whenever we give astern, we have to make sure that the lifeboat goes astern. That is also a part of quarterly inspection of lifeboat engines. So after this, we have to inspect. Now this is the propeller shaft of the lifeboat. So we have to inspect, we have to grease this quarterly basis. We have to check whatever greasing points are there. Based on that, we have to grease regularly quarterly basis, and we have to check again the if any rust particles are causing obstruction to the rotation of the crankshaft. So that is very important. Other than this, we have to check the fuel filter. It should be clean and it should not be damaged. And not inspecting of lifeboat engine doesn't mean only inspecting the engine, but you have so also have to inspect this exhaust. Now this exhaust, which you can see here, now it has a self-closing arrangement, so to prevent the ingress of the water. So that is why this also need to be inspected, because most of the time this gets rusted and they may flow off in the water because of the rust and because of any of the causes. So we have to make sure that this arrangement is there in your lifeboat, in the lifeboat engine exhaust. So also we have to inspect in the lifeboat engine, we have to inspect whether the laggings, whatever the laggings which are running, they should be clear of the bilge water area. The exhaust lagging should be clean, dry, and provide suitable protection. So, and also the V belt which is going and the starter motor, we have to inspect that on a quarterly basis. So all these things are very important to check in lifeboat engines quarterly basis. So especially the area where you have rust, that area should be more given more attention. After quarterly inspection, we have annual inspection, and annual inspection is also of lifeboat engines only. So the lifeboat engine annual inspection should be done as per the manufacturer's requirement, and the crankcase oil and the propeller shaft gearbox oil of lifeboat engine should be renewed. So after the IMO 2020, we have to make sure that whatever fuel we are changing for the lifeboat engine, that should comply with the requirements of IMO 2020, because it is a very high point, very high probability that PSC may come and inspect that what type of engine fuel you are using in the lifeboat. So that is very important. And also you have to make sure that they are renewed every year, and it is also recommended to renew the fuel filters, the valve clearance, and the injectors of the lifeboat engine. So this was all about the lifeboat engine's annual inspection. So here I conclude my lifeboat inspection video, where I have completed all the three parts, especially this is the third part of the lifeboat video inspection. So here I conclude, guys. If you have any doubts, please comment. And if you like this video, please like and subscribe. And thanks for watching, guys.